Well, a pretty bright individual once said that if you don't learn from history, you're destined to repeat it. And I think we have an example of a young man who clearly didn't learn from history. 2 weeks ago, people will remember that we had a bit of a high-profile street race in Abbotsford. It involved six high-end expensive vehicles and young people essentially trying to use South Fraser Way, one of the busiest stretches in Abbotsford, as a bit of a racetrack. That resulted in those six vehicles being impounded and all six drivers receiving tickets. Well, one of those drivers last night happened to be in the area of McClure Road in Livingston. He was traveling at a rate of speed which was more than double the posted speed limit. Speed limit in that area is 60 kilometers an hour, and he was doing 133 in a Chrysler 300. So this is the same Chrysler 300 that was impounded just 2 weeks ago. So to cut to the chase, the end of the story is, once again, that vehicle's been impounded. Once again, that driver has received a ticket, this time for excessive speeding. And once again, the family vehicle will be at the tow yard as opposed to in the driveway. The theme here, though, from a road safety standpoint, is that there are some individuals out there that just don't get it, aren't prepared to get it, and are continuing to make bad choices that could potentially impact us all on the roadways.
How is McClure for accidents and crashes? Is it one of your top areas?
Well, it's a busy area because obviously freeway traffic comes off onto McClure. We have a major shopping mall in that area. It's a mix of business and a lot of residential housing. So there's a busy intersection there. It's a busy stretch of road. And on top of all that, it's also a truck route. So for someone to do 133 kilometers an hour on a truck route, 5 o'clock on a Sunday afternoon, obviously they are putting themselves at risk and everyone else in and around that area, both in vehicles and pedestrian traffic as well.
When did the vehicle get released?
Well, so best guess is that it would have been impounded for a week, which would have brought us up to about the 21st of April. The family would have had it then for a week, and it looks like we're taking it back. So potentially every other week, if you're looking for that vehicle and you're a family member, if it's not in the driveway, you might want to check the impound yard.
How was his attitude this time?
Well, let's say we had a conversation with this young man. I don't know that that conversation shed any light on what was transpiring. What was abundantly clear was that he was interacting with two other drivers, one of a Ford Mustang and one of a Cadillac Escalade. We don't know if that would have morphed into more street racing, but clearly there's an issue here. That issue involves both the young man, his choices, and how the family is dealing with some of his choices. For the second time now in 3 weeks, he's returned home without the family car and with a ticket in hand.